Welcome to this brief guide on how to animate logos in PowerPoint. So you've been working on your presentation and you've got a couple of logos for either your products or your business or your organization, and you'd love to be able to really make them pop and stand out in your PowerPoint deck. Today I'm going to show you how to make that a reality. Here you can see I have both the OneNote and the Outlook logos. But one of the things to note here is that these are not PNG or bitmap files, they are SVG files, or Scalable Vector Graphics files. This allows them to dynamically scale without blurring. There's another benefit to these particular files, is it means that the images are actually made up of lots of different shapes. So what we can do is actually to right click, and we can choose to ungroup these. That can be done in the group menu and selecting ungroup. Now, because I imported this particular SVG file, it's going to ask me if I want to convert it to a drawing object. I'm going to say no in this instance. There's another way we can do it as well, where you can right click and you can select the option that says convert to shape. This will automatically do that conversion for you without you needing to approve it via that pop-up. But now you'll see that my OneNote logo has been split into all its individual pieces, which means that I can now individually move these around. This is a great way to be able to find out all the different components that make up a particular logo if you'd like. So now I'm going to use Control Shift D or the duplicate slide option in the context menu to create a duplicate copy of this particular slide. Head back to slide one and then zoom out a bit so that we can see the space around the slide area. What you'll see now is that I'm beginning to move all of the individual pieces of the OneNote logo off the active slide area. This is important because we don't want to be able to see them when the slide is active in our presentation, but we still want them to technically be there. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to activate my slideshow from this slide. And what you'll see when I transition between the two slides is there really is no transition. It's just they're not there and then they're there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a transition, which if I select slide two, select my transitions option, and then select the awesome morph transition. Now, when I slide my mouse across to the side here, I can also then adjust the duration of my transition. I'm going to make this nice and slow so that it's a smooth, gradual transition between the two slides. You can adjust this based on your needs. Now that I've got my transition done, I'll select slide one, and I'm going to activate my slideshow yet again. And it looks very similar to before, but now when I do my transition, I'll get a very smooth, gradual movement across of the logo. And there we go. Now, obviously this transition can be used to great effect. In this instance, I could actually split up the Outlook logo as well and would have this effect where it's the question, was this difficult to do? And the answer is no. And then you'll see that the icons will all come in as well. And just to show you how complex these logos can be, when I ungroup this, it's actually going to be pretty crazy. There's a lot of different pieces that make up the Outlook logo, whilst it looks pretty similar. But just like before with the OneNote logo, I can adjust that as well. And that is how you animate logos in PowerPoint through the use of vector files. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it makes your presentations in the future just that much more engaging. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.